August 2014 was one of the lowest chapters of my life. Having graduated university in 2012 with a 2-1 in event management, I still found myself working a job I did not enjoy, very depressed and literally on the verge of a breakdown. A friend of mine blessed me with a week at Ashburnham Retreat, a week that would divinely alter the direction of my life. I sort of, in a way I had never before, and during a time of prayer, I became inspired to create a talk show to help other women step out into their purpose. Full of insecurities, I didn't act immediately. However, I discussed it with my pastors at Word of Faith and Theo Ambrose from MediaNet Gospel, who I'd worked with previously on events with GB Promotions. I received a great amount of encouragement and support, so began to plan and outline the structure of the show, but nothing materialized. I ran ahead of myself and stopped praying for direction. I was completely reliant on myself and those around me. I found myself in a season of unemployment, awaiting for feedback on an application to my dream job. During the wait, I began to realize the root of my lack of progression. I stopped involving God. I began to pray as I did whilst on the retreat. I wanted to know what God wanted me to do. After 2 years of seeking clarity, God confirmed the assignment had not changed, and No Ordinary Woman chat show was birthed. I'm your host, Miss Kazmak. This show is being put together to encourage young girls and women to go out there and walk into your God-given purpose. When we're looking into society of today, we see there is some women who have great influence, not always portrayed in a positive manner. However, there is a large proportion of other women in our society who are doing fantastic things within our community, but yet we hear very little about these women. So on this show, we're going to share with you, in our view, who those No Ordinary Women are. So don't touch that dial, stay right there, go and put the kettle on and tune back in to No Ordinary Woman chat show.
Love. I Love Afro. I'm just going to hear about you guys. So did you guys, I mean, how did the journey start, first and foremost?
I probably should start because it kind of started with me.
Yeah, okay.
So, gosh, going back, I think it's 10 years now. I've been natural for 10 years now. Mm-hmm. Not particularly growing my hair the whole time. I've cut it shorter and coloured it and done all sorts of things. But I had relaxed hair before and it was short, and right. I used to do all sorts of different styles and colours, and I decided that I wanted to go Mary J. Blige blonde.
And have the blonde look.
Oh yeah, gosh. So I did it and it was nice. But then as your relaxer grows out and it's time for you to relax your hair again, when I did, it was kind of just breaking and literally flying out as I was blow drying the hair. It was just flying out and I was like, wow. So I went to the hairdressers.
You saw me. Why are you laughing?
You recall that then?
Like,
she recalls. She,
and she's like, proper better than laughing. Like, it's so good to see someone's hair go. Like,
but you know what they say? Every disappointment's a blessing.
Yeah, exactly. Every story I had, every moan, she was on the other end. But to kind of fast forward, went to the hairdressers. They was like, look, you can't put any more relaxers in your hair. Not right now, anyway. Mm-hmm. I was like, okay, because I can do a texturizer. And they was like, no, it's the same thing. You need a break. And I was like, well, what am I supposed to do? So they just said, have a break. Let's cut it a bit shorter. So literally, I went to like a number one, number two, and just had to just rock that for a while.
Oh my gosh.
As it grew, I was just like, oh wow, like it's curly and it's soft. And you know, I said to Natasha, and I said to like one of my other friends, my best friend, I'm gonna give this 1 year and let's see what happens. And literally just gave it 1 year, and then my hair just started growing. Natasha started getting interested in, oh, I want to go natural too. And yeah, then I suppose hand over to Tasha now.
Yeah, because it was really weird because I'd been natural before anyway. But never like Sasha had been natural. So I'd used to blow my hair out. I'd have it in twists. I'd have it in plaits. You know, I'd never just have it out and do a twist out or anything. All I ever did when I had it out was actually have an afro. Do you see what I mean?
Yeah.
Whereas when I saw Sasha taking care of her, I was like, she's doing her hair in twists. She's measuring her length. It was, I've been on YouTube. I said, YouTube for what? I thought it was just for music.
Yeah.
There's a natural world out there.
So what year was this? Roughly.
Gosh, so, 10 years. So 2006.
Oh, wow. So people was actually putting stuff on YouTube back then?
Yeah, I think probably like come 2000, I went maybe about a year later, about 2007, I was looking on. Because there was some other, they were like picture websites. So it's literally just photos and you see year zero, then you see year one, you're like, oh my gosh, hair's like, it was here and I was here.
Oh, so you can actually see their journey,
see their progress. Right. So it was all kind of photos, and then I discovered YouTube and I was like, wow, there's like people putting up pictures and showing you how to do things. I learned to do, and the two of us would be on there like on the phone like, oh, I'm gonna try this flat twist, let's try that, let's see.
Okay, so it's quite encouraging and giving
the thing
inspiration.
Is what encouraged me even more about Sasha's journey was that she couldn't chemo. Like, I can chemo and do all that kind of thing. I don't really like that. But you know what it is? You know when you think you go natural, you know, you've got to be able to plait. You've got to be this great expert. You know, I used to plait your hair when you were young, right? Because we're 8 years apart.
Oh, so are you guys?
So it's a family affair. And I remember her auntie, my aunt, her mum, always used to say to me, oh, could you plait Sasha's hair? Because, you know, I don't do it as good as you because my fingers are too, what we should say, they're too chunky.
Too chunky.
I used to do it. But Sasha's hair really took off. So for me, it was an inspiration because I felt like, well, if she can do it and it's looking great, do you know what? I'm going to cut my relaxer out again and try again.
Oh, right.
So, that was it.
So
Thank you.
In regards to your products, I mean, is it just for natural hair? Is it creams? Is it hair oil? Or, you know, what is it?
Well, we've got a range of 7 products at the moment, and they range from washing and cleansing products. So we've got shampoo, conditioner, we've got moisturiser, we've got 2 butter melts, which are kind of, you can use for sealants and as styling products, and we've got a hydrating hold cream, which you can use as a moisturiser and a styling product as well.
Okay, so can I use that?
You can use it on chemical hair, or even if you're another race and your hair's slightly drier or curly, you could use some of the products. Obviously, some will maybe a little bit too heavy, but you kind of, you know, there is something for all there. And okay. some can be used on skin as well.
Mm. Oh, what? So yeah. you actually do for...
Yeah, because yeah. our Sheer Moisture Lotion, that's a two-in-one. So it's for your hair, moisturises your hair as well as your body.
That's so clever. Yeah. Oh, my gosh. So viewers, you can buy two-in-one.
That's right. Yeah.
Oh, that's fantastic. So moving forward in regards to your products, I mean, do you guys come from like a scientific background? Because you actually make your own products, right? Yeah. So did you guys do science, do chemistry, physics and all that kind of stuff? Or
gosh, I did it at school, but that's about it. No, not really. So but I think if you want to get into this kind of thing, you have to have an interest in it. And there are courses and things to read up about to find out. But you don't have to have a scientific background to do it. I think you just have to have a passion for it and then literally go. And I mean, how we started, as I said before, once my hair kind of grew and we were sourcing products from all sorts from the US and falling in love with them, and then they stopped shipping here and we just got frustrated and thought, you know what, there's nothing here, why? And then we decided that we're gonna try and make our own. We said it as a joke at first, but then after research we just found that there was places that teach you how to make products, at least like a starter course. And then we went on that, and then every week we was kind of going, I was popping over to the Tasha's, trying and error.
Because we are our products.
You were just trying it on yourselves, right.
And because we are natural, we are the ones that use the products. We are the products. We were the perfect candidates to try it on. And then we had friends, family that wanted to try the products, and it grew from there. And I was like, we need to start selling this. Yeah. And my mum was like, yes! Okay, mum, steady. And then that's when like regulations came in, and you had to sit before you could sell. You know, there are regulations that you've got to follow. So we did courses on that kind of thing to be able to like get your product from your kitchen out there onto the market. And it happened. You know, we got it moving. We got ourselves 2 years. It took us to. Do you remember, Sasha? It took us 2 years to make one product because we got so.
It's too thick. It's too thin.
It's too thin. Everything was. Oh, it's not ready. It's not ready. And my mum was like, "What do you mean it's not ready? I've been using it for how long? It's ready. It's ready.
I think that's okay. I think the thing is as well that you get caught up in, because I often used to say, "Oh, it's not working in everyone's hair. Like that person's hair's dry. It's not working for that person. It works for me, but it might not work for Tasha. But it doesn't have to work for everybody." There's something in the range that works for everyone. And yeah, you can't get wrapped up in that. Just, you know, it's a good product, people are praising it. And the thing is, if you get got your family and friends or our mums and aunties saying,
and they're your biggest critique,
because they'll just tell you the truth.
That's good.
Wow. So in regards to you, young Kelsey, I mean, you know, obviously listen to these ladies' story, because you're a hairdresser, and I know, well, obviously you're a vlogger, and your biggest fan. So how do you, I mean, like watching you on YouTube, I see that you've got like thousands of subscribers, so many hits on your videos. How do you do it? Because you're a mum as well, you're a wife, you know, like you said, you're self-employed. So how do you do it? And you know, what is the primary focus?
Okay, basically, I want to just take you back to how I became natural or returned natural. It was same time as yourself. It was 2006. I was pregnant with my son.
Right.
2005, and I decided I'm not going to relax my hair anymore, because you know when you go through pregnancy after you have the child, your hair falls out, and I didn't want to have straight relaxed hair. And after a year, my hair grew so much, and I one day stopped blow drying it straight like yourself. I was blow drying my hair straight because I didn't know what to do with it, but I knew that I can get it straight. And one day, my hair was wet and I realized that my hair was curly and I wanted to keep it curly. And so like yourself, I just went, just typed up, my hair is afro and curly, how do I keep the curls? And then all these posts came, these websites came up, these products came up, YouTube came up, and I was like, oh my goodness, that is it. I'm like a kid in a candy shop. And you know, so I was really hungry to learn. Basically, I just got really inspired on YouTube. I saw other women demonstrating their hair, how they did it, and I wanted to do that. I wanted to network and meet other women like myself internationally and just network in that way. And I just made that time. I made that time to, I just had that passion, that desire to just get up there, get a camera and just do my thing. It was just burning. It was just burning inside me. And as the years went by, you know, my tools got better. It is hard. It's really, really hard to find that time when the kids are asleep. I will then, you know, get my things out, get my makeup out and start, you know, doing my thing. It's only when they're sleeping that I can actually, you know, venture out and do what I can't do it when they're awake because they need my time, or when they're at school, when I'm not working. But it's definitely a desire that I have to just reach out to other women, other girls that don't know. And surprisingly, there's people that still don't know, and there's still so much information out there, and they still want to know, you know, how did you get your hair like that? Can you do this? Can you do that? And so it is a commitment, and it is quite hard. But I don't want to do stuff for the sake of it. I want to do it because I'm passionate. This is real. This is what I'm going through, and I want to show you. And because I'm passionate, it's going to be authentic. It's not going to be, it's really good. And I just want it to be, you know. And I think that's when they actually feel it as well. They feel the authenticity.
Definitely.
So it's just managing my time really with the kids, juggling with the kids and working. Sometimes I'm up like hours on end just editing. It could be like 10 hours straight I'm editing.
So you edit all your own videos? Wow, yeah. They are so amazing.
Thank you.
Viewers, check out Young Kelsea. Subscribe, you will not be disappointed. And remember, I told you that. Anyway, on No Ordinary Woman chat show. But ladies, thank you so much for sharing that. But in regards to you doing your videos and, you know, obviously your hairdresser as well, you're self-employed, how do you find time to just, like, basically go to different events and things like that? Because I know you guys are kind of, like, connected together, right? Because obviously this natural movement that's taken over, that I have taken over with it.
You'll be there, Zay. You'll be there.
Well, I haven't had that revelation just yet.
You'll get it, my love.
I'm still into the crack cream. You know, the one cream I just make it look so. Yes. Pray for me, y'all. Pray for me. But yeah, but in terms of, you know, these events, there's so many other women that are actually, you know, so involved in this movement. And I call it a movement because obviously, you know, we've been chemically damaging our hair all these years. And then all of a sudden, it's like, we want to be natural. This is how we've been born. But yet we have to find out about our own hair on YouTube.
Yeah, it's almost like a mind retraining.
You know,
right?
It's just absolutely bonkers.
You know what? Being ourselves is beautiful.
Yeah.
And that's what it is. So no disrespect to you that you wear your relaxer or anything like that. Because I don't even think it's about that. You know, like, because I think a lot of people do feel like when you're natural, oh, you're part of a movement.
Yeah.
It seems like it's not, because I think straight away people start to think that, oh, well, I've got a relaxer, so straight away it's, you know, I'd love to do that, but I just can't. You've got to do things when you're ready.
I think what it is to show people that you can have relaxer, weaves, or whatever you want to have, but there's another choice, there's another option to kind of almost... Well, it's not do nothing, but have your own hair. That's just another
option.
And your
own hair is good enough.
Exactly.
It's good enough.
But it boils down to your identity, isn't it? Of, when I say identity, but it's like accepting who you really are. Mm. And I think, you know, I mean, I like to put weaves in. I like the relaxer. But to be quite honest, that's what I've been grown up to know. I haven't really... grown up to know about my own natural hair apart from when I was a child, and I think that's a lot for a lot of other people.
I think most of us.
But it's just really, like you said, it's just really that mindset of switching over. But I think it's really sad at the same time that we don't really accept and fully embrace ourselves.
It's almost like we're relearning about our natural selves.
That's just so deep. It's really quite sad.
It is, but I think then you've got to look at the... But you never know what people's story is. So, like, when you see someone with a wig or if you see them with extensions or whatever, it might not be that, oh, I don't want to be natural, I don't like it. Mm. It could be that, actually, I'm protecting my hair.
That's it.
I'm doing protective this week.
Yeah.
Or it could be... I think the problem arises when somebody... wears a wig, weave, or chemically treats their hair and detests
their own hair.
Right. That's where I think the problem is.
Yeah.
And I think that, you know, we can all have preferences. Mm-hmm. So, and that's what's great about are here, you know. Whilst we can look at it as a negative thing that, you know, oh my gosh, we only chemically treat our hair, there's so many different options. Mm. We are so versatile
as black women.
You know, you can have curly, you can have straight, you can have whatever, you can have locks. And we look beautiful, we carry that. We look good. And I think we should embrace that. But the only time I think it's a problem is when we say the natural is not beautiful.
But then when you think about media as well, you know, you look at the music industry, you see so many of the ladies with their long flowy hair and all this makeup and everything else. And yes, we all wear makeup, and I do believe wearing makeup is just to enhance your natural beauty anyway. But then when you do have, you know, certain, like I said before and in the opening, about certain various different leading ladies that are out there that have great influence, but they're not always portrayed in a positive manner, because they're kind of like sending you this kind of image of this is how it is to be beautiful.
Do you know what I mean?
Kind of thing.
Yeah.
And, you know, what would you say to our young girls that may be watching and don't really like the way they look? They don't like their hair. They don't think they're very gorgeous. What would you say to those young girls? I mean, if young Koki, you could speak to one of them.
Yeah, I would say that God's made you the way you are. So, you know, everything he makes is good, you know, nothing he makes is bad, you know. So, you know, you're made in his image. So that was revelation to me as well, that God made me and he loves me the way I am. And this is what's come out of my head. It's, you know, it's beautiful, it's kinky, it's curly. And I can do so much of it. I can wear it straight. I can wear it curly. I can do twist out, braid outs. I can do whatever I want. It's so versatile. And, yeah, that's what I would say.
Okay, thank you. And Tasha and Sasha, if you can also share some of your challenges, you know, because just in case any of the viewers that are actually listening, they're thinking about also setting up, doing similar kind of business like yourselves, if you can just tell them about, you know, the positives, the negatives, like the challenges you face, what you've had to overcome, just, you know, just share it with them and just tell them.
I would say the challenges of having a business, being independent, small, you're up against companies that have lots of money, but don't let that put you off. You're also time. If you're working and it's a sideline, it's about trying to be able to balance the two.
Yeah.
That's really hard. And also, I think the passion. You have to have the passion there, because if you don't, then when you can't go to the parties, when you can't go to certain events because you've got to sacrifice because your business needs you, that's when the passion has to outweigh the...
carry you through.
Yeah, to carry you through. And also, I'd like to say that, you know, when you open a business, you know, we hear stories, we read in magazines that, you know, oh, you know, this business within 2 years, it was off the ground and they made millions. That's hardly any businesses. But, you know, I think sometimes we can feel like our business isn't working because we're not getting the return that we want instantly.
Mm.
But you've got to be in it for the long haul, and don't give up. Don't give up and don't be fearful. Don't worry about your competition. Stay in your lane, stay focused. And I think that is what will carry you through, as well as having the passion.
Thank you. Do you have anything to add to that, Sasha?
No, I think she said everything. The fear is obviously a big thing as well. You mm-hmm. need to kind of believe in yourself, believe in your products,
mm-hmm.
and believe that there's people out there
mm-hmm.
that want your products and that want to hear from you and want to hear whether you're making hair products or whether you're doing videos or for makeup or hair. People want to hear your story.
Mm-hmm.
They want to hear, and that's what you need to be thinking of, because mm-hmm. it's lovely. You were saying one of the nice things is when you get testimonials of, oh, you know, I saw you, someone told me about your product, I bought your product, and I try it, and I just love it, and I like my hair now, and this is the style I've done. Or, you know, someone comes to you with a problem, you suggest something to them, and then they come back, and, you know, they're happy. Mm. That's, like, really something that makes you feel warm and makes you want to carry on when those days are hard,
totally.
And it's 2 a.m, and there's an event the next day, and you're still labelling
up.
You're still labelling up, and you're just like, oh, why? And then you go and everyone's like, thank you, thank you, thank you. Then you know that that's why. And you know you're doing the right thing.
And definitely. That's when you know when you're really in your purpose, because there's something that I listen to with, I like to listen and read a lot of books as well. And Dr. Mars Monroe, he made a statement in one of his videos, and he was like basically saying about, how do you know that this is my purpose? And he said something on the line of, if it's whatever it is that you want to do, it's only just about focusing and benefiting you. I'm just kind of paraphrasing what you said. It's only going to benefit you, then you're not really living in your purpose. But if it's going to help other people and even set up a stance for another generation, then you're really living in a purpose. And what I'm getting from you ladies is that you're living testimonies of your purpose, you know. And like you said, you know, it started off with the bad, you know, wanting to look a certain way. And it comes to vanity as well, doesn't it? Do you know what I mean? Look at us. You know, we're trying to look like a celebrity. And the truth of the matter is, I don't know Mary J. Blige. You know, but it could have even just been a weave that she had in her hair. But because it looks so fantastic, we're thinking, oh, God, we can't get that look, you know? Mm-hmm. And then this is the consequences. But the blessings is, I'm looking at your hair and I'm just thinking, how am I going to get a hair? I'm just going to have to go pack some buy one weave. Do you know what I mean? So, ladies.
No, you're not. You're going to start.
You don't have to.
Well, like I said, I'm going to get that revelation.
Well, don't worry, it's coming to
so, you know, but basically, but you've got the colour. Do you know what I mean? And you look beautiful.
Thank you.
And it's your own hair. It's just like,
it's possible, girl.
You know, it's possible.
I think we all look beautiful.
We do.
You know,
we
and that's do. Not being vain about it. I think it's being you and owning it.
Yeah.
And you know, not everybody's beautiful. It's for everybody. But if you are happy with you, then you've made a start.
That's right.
You're a winner. You're a winner from them. Because I think that's the key for the young girls. That be you, because if you are actually trying to be somebody else, you're going to be changing yourself for the rest of your life, and you will never be able to keep it up. So be you and be comfortable.
And that's so true. I mean, even for myself, you know, I struggled with my own identity as well. And I think that's a lot for a lot of us as women, because it's just like, we've never really been told from when we're small, you're a princess, you're beautiful, look at your hair, look on your mouth, look on your... Do you know what I'm saying? And I say these things to, like, my grand...
Wow.
Listen, I mean, I have my grandchildren, listen, my godchildren. But with my godchildren, I even say to my, you know, my little kids and that, and I say to them, you know, you're beautiful, you're a prince, you're a king, you're a queen. To really just make them know that they are special. Do you know what I mean? They're unique. And we need to keep on plugging this to our young people. And even you, the mature mother, or, you know, the wife that is maybe just doing so many different things, and you look at your thinking, yes, Lord God, I've let myself go. You know what? You're still beautiful. You're gorgeous. Do you know what I mean? And I think it's like you said, embrace yourself.
It is. Believe
in
that.
Yourself.
Yeah. You know.
You know. So... ladies, I just want to thank you all for coming to the No Ordinary Woman Chat Show.
Thank you for having us.
Thank you. It's been absolutely fabulous. What these ladies have shared is real. Do you know what I mean? And I'm sure... Oh, actually, ladies, if you can just say where they can find out about your products.
I was just about to say that.
Wow. Oh, so with I Love Afro, we have a website. It's called iloveafro.co.uk. Facebook, which is I Love Afro UK. We're on Instagram, which is I Love Afro UK. And we're on Twitter, which is I Love Afro. So you can find us all there.
Thank you. And Yon Kelsey?
You can find me on Instagram as Yon Kelsey, YonKelc, and on YouTube, Yon Kelsey. That's me.
Okay, guys. So you've heard from these ladies. So check them out, check them out, check them out. And I hope you was blessed, because I know I was blessed from these gorgeous lady. And I'll see you next time on No Ordinary Woman Chat Show.
Bye.
See ya.
Bye.